Welcome to Programming with Professor Califf. Today, I'd like to talk to you about getting started using Java with VS Code. So if you're using Eclipse, I have a separate video. I encourage you to go check that one out. But I've switched to using Visual Studio Code for most things. And so this is a video that's introductory, telling you how to set up Visual Studio Code and write your first Java program. So the first thing we need to do is to go find Visual Studio Code and install it. So I'm going to start by just searching for VS Code. And once I get here, I'm going to actually go to the documentation. Now you might think we want to go to download, but I want to get the specific package that's appropriate for Java. So the easiest way to find that is go to docs, and then we're going to click on Java here in this side menu and getting started. So we can see here, there is a setting up VS Code for Java development. And so what you want to do is to click on the appropriate install the coding pack. Now, if you're working on Linux as opposed to Windows or macOS, you will need to go through finding the download and then getting the extensions separately once you've downloaded Visual Studio Code for your system and gotten that up. You can actually choose the install the Java extension pack down here. Or if you already have VS Code set up, then you can do the install the Java extension pack or do it from within VS Code, and I'll show you where you can do that. So you're just going to pick your system, install the coding pack. Now that is going to take you a little bit of time to install. Pause the video and come back when you have that downloaded. Okay, we have the coding pack, so let's run it. And you'll need to accept the license. So make sure you're happy with the licenses and then click Next. Then this will install both the Java Development Kit that you need and Visual Studio Code. Configure things, install the extensions you need, and so forth. Click that. Now notice that mine is very, very fast, because I actually have all of this installed already. So yours may take a little longer. Feel free to pause, wait until it's finished. Once you're finished, go ahead and launch and start the video back up. So now here we are in Visual Studio Code. You may get something about customizing and setting up your system. You can pick a color theme. So I'm using a dark color theme. There are light color themes as well. Pick something that fits your desires. You've got quite a few choices. You can actually take a look at what they look like by simply using the arrow keys to go through this. So feel free to pick what you want. I will stick with my dark. And then we're going to go ahead and start with opening a folder. So close, if you've got a getting started tab, go ahead and close that. If you've got a welcome tab, whatever you've got, go ahead and close that. Notice these tabs over here are of interest. You won't have as many as I do right now. Before we go in and start this, I do want to point out the extensions. So the part of what got installed, you should have the Java extension pack and related extensions at this point. So that includes a debugger, a test runner, language support, various items. If you're interested in working with VS Code in other languages, there are extensions for other languages as well. You can simply go pick the language you want to work in. Suppose you've been programming for a while, you use Perl. Then you can search for Perl up here and it will show you all the possible things, and you simply click the install button. So pretty straightforward to use. If you work with other people And for my students, this is something that we will definitely be using, the LiveShare extension. This is great for getting help from me. So search for LiveShare and install that for sure. But right now, let's focus on just writing our first Java program. So the very top thing here is the Explorer, which helps you navigate the file system and so forth. We're going to pick this bottom button, Create Java Project. So click that, go ahead and choose No Build Tools, and then find the place in your system where you want to put this. Now, what we're going to end up with is a folder inside the folder you've just selected. So be aware of that. I'm going to select the project location and then type in a Java project name. So I'm going to just call this first Java project and hit enter. Now we have this set up. Notice that we've now gotten a getting started, which has some learning opportunities, customize your setup and so forth. Go ahead and close that. Now, where we want to put our source code is in the SRC, which is an abbreviation for source folder here. Now, there's actually already a file here, which we could take a look at, but we're going to go ahead and write our own. So I'm going to actually delete that. So delete, and that will move it to the recycle bin. And I'm going to make sure that I've got source open. I'm going to go to this button right here, which says new file. You can come up here and say new file. An advantage here is if we use this button, we're going to get a chance to go ahead and put in the file name, which can be helpful to us. So I'm going to call this hello world.java. We're going to be very traditional and write hello world as our first program and hit enter. Now, when I create a file in this way, a Java file, I'll usually get a chance right away to say what class I want or if I want it to be one of these other things. So we do want a class. So we're going to pick class Hello World. And I like my braces down on the next line, so I'm going to do that. And we're going to have this just have a main. So I'm going to actually take advantage of some of what VS Code will do for us and start typing the word main. And this is going to pop up, including one that has this sort of box here. That's an indication that there's a code snippet that I can take and use that will get pasted in for me. So I'm going to click on that, and that's going to give me all of this formula, which if you're new to Java, you do not understand yet. But by the time we get to the end of this series, you will understand everything here. And this is where my program will start. Right now, we're going to write very simple programs where all we have in our class is a main. So now I'm going to have it print Hello World, and that's going to start out with System, which is a class that Java provides that does things for interacting with the computer. Then I have a dot. Then I'm going to use out, which is a print stream. So this is where I print things that I want to have show up on the screen. And then dot. And then I want to choose print line, which will print a line and then go to the next line. And in here, I'm going to put what I want to have print, which is just hello, comma, world, exclamation point. Then I'm going to save. If you save, you may not have things format right away. I actually have my system set up so that it will format for me. In order to format code, you can go right click. I right clicked on the document and went here and said format document. So let me make this so it's not formatted the way I would have it. And then right click and say format document. You can see that it changed back. Now, by default, you'll probably have the opening curly braces at the end of the line here instead of the beginning of the next line. Don't worry about that right now. I'm going to go ahead and add a comment here. So we have a couple different kinds of comments. This is what we call a JavaDoc style comment, which we standardly have. So for any class, any public function we write other than main. And this is going to explain what this class is or what this program does. So I'm just going to call this simple Hello World program. And one thing we always want to have on our classes is what we call an at author clause, where you're going to put your full name, or at least first and last name. You don't have to include your middle. That then tells people this is what this program does and this is who wrote it. And that's an important thing you always want to provide. So now let's try running our program. And we can do this in a variety of ways. The way you'll typically do it here, we just click on the Run button, which then will pop up a terminal. In this case, we're just printing to what we call a console or terminal. And so that's done a bunch of things. This is everything that's required to build and run the program. And then we'll see the output from the program, which is in this case, this Hello World message. If I changed this so that now we have Java programmers, save that off and try running it again, we can see that it has changed so that it says Hello Java programmers. So this is just a quick little taste of Java programming in VS Code, pretty straightforward. You'll see various capabilities of Java and VS Code as we work through the series. Hope you enjoy getting started and do make sure that you are doing it. Don't just watch me. You won't learn anything from just watching me. We learn programming by programming. So if you haven't yet, go ahead, get VS Code down or whatever IDE you want to work in. Get it set up. Go back through if you need to. Write that Hello World program. And then I hope to see you in the next video. Next one will actually be on what variables are all about. And then the next one we'll get in and actually get in the code and play with them again.